Hey guys, my name is Sucharita. This is Film Companion Reviews. You're watching Not a Movie Review. And right now, I am not going to be reviewing Atomic Blonde. पहले क्लियर कर रही हूँ मैं. दिस इज गोइंग टू बी एन ओड टू द ऑसमनेस दैट इज चार्लीज थेरन. तो अगर इफ यू डोंट लाइक गर्ल्स फॉलिंग ओवर अदर गर्ल्स, यू बेटर ऑफ वॉचिंग जब हैरी मेट सीजन वन मोर टाइम. एटॉमिक ब्लॉन्ड फाइनली लेट्स अ वुमन प्रोटैगनिस्ट गो वेयर प्रेशियस फ्यू फिल्म्स हैव टेकन हर बिफोर, टू अ लैंड वेयर शी नीड्स नो मैन टू लुक आफ्टर हर, टू अ प्लेस वेयर द एस्टैब्लिशमेंट पुट्स देयर एंटायर फेथ इन दिस वुमन. की बहन तू जा मार दे सबको, ये ले चाकू. The year is 1989, location Berlin. The wall is about to come down, there is pagal kar dene wali tension in the air, and Germans are already inexplicably nuts about David Hasselhoff. Is sab ke beech, Charlize is Lorraine, an MI6 agent deployed to Berlin to retrieve a list with names of other super secret agents written on it, kyunki apparently is sab ke beech mein wo list sabse zyada zaruri hai. The rest of the film is kind of like a whodunit thriller. List kahan hai? Double agent kaun hai? James McAvoy Mr. Tumnus tha kya, kisi ko yaad hai? Charlize Theron is freaking amazing. If you want a list of all her accomplishments, just YouTube her SNL opening monologue from 2014.
I've also never had bad sex.
And here, she's kicking some serious butt. For real, somehow with about 27 bruises on her face, the woman just gets hotter. And I like this whole villain and angry woman on a mission thing she's got going on. Fast and Furious, The Huntsman, Winter's War, Mad Max Ki Furiosa, iconic. One of the prettiest actors ever and not afraid of literal grease on her face. But sadly, that's where the movie's charm ends. James McAvoy is so cute, he's hilarious, and seems to fit hand in glove in every part written for him in every film ever. Along with John Goodman, Sofia, Boutella, all actors of a caliber, mat kisi bhi script mein char chand lag jaye. But screenplay to actors nahi bacha sakte na. Sure, it's always fun to see a movie begin with an interrogation sequence and then shown in flashback ki aisa hua, kaisa hua. And director David Leitch? So by the way, he's directing Deadpool 2 right now, so that's awesome. He goes seamlessly from the present to the past and back and forward and stuff, but this shtick gets old really fast. There's only that many times I can see Charlize light up a cigarette mysteriously in close-up. She does it about 10 times. Kitna smoke karna padta hoga na set par aise baar baar? Retake pe retake, cancer pe cancer. Anyway, there's too many times she gets ambushed. You know she's gonna smash her way out of it because future mein interrogation to chal hi rahi hai. To ye sirf set piece purpose ke liye scene dal diya. Not that it's not gorgeous to look at. Frames designed with mathematic precision, eerie and beautiful neon lighting, ek movement choreographed in ek stunt. Lekin all this felt unnecessary and to be honest, slightly distracting. Somehow, these things kept me from really getting involved with the character. You know, kya hota hai? When you feel connected with what you're watching, even though the director might not necessarily tell you ki is character ki backstory kya hai, you're so invested, apne aap hi dimag mein aa jati hai kahani, hai na? Wo nahi hua. The music though has been designed to be noticed. Extra effort gaya usme dikhta hai. Songs flow seamlessly from flashback and forward. Most of them have nothing to do with what's actually taking place in the scene, just random era appropriate late 80s pop tunes. While this may be random to some people, मेरे को तो बड़ा सही लगा, quirky. जैसे दर्द करा रहा था ना दम लगा के हर्षा के एंड में. The most amazing sequence from the movie though is one without any music. Charlize is in a building, only foley and natural sound, going down from one floor to the next and just straight up killing people. It looked like a couple of scenes stitched together to form one long sequence. Stunts being shared by Charlize and kabhi kabhi aisa oops, baal ke piche muh chup gaya, body double. But oh my god, this is what you get when the director is himself a stuntman. Breathtaking. And also that is the problem. Despite many small mazedar moments and scenes, as a whole, Atomic Blonde isn't enjoyable like a movie should be. So on a scale of 1 to 10, Atomic Blonde is 10 minutes long. That stairwell action scene I was talking about, 10 minutes. Bas wahi pe paisa vasool. Obviously, one full Charlize and Sofia sex scene has been removed by erstwhile Pehlaj Nelani. Lekin online hai apparently. Mere ko link mila nahi, dhoond ke comment mein dalo na please. And subscribe also.